Hi guys, Brian here from Wheeling Cameras. In this video I'm going to show you something that's new to Wheeling Cameras, which is the Insta360 One camera, which I have here. Basically what this camera is a 4K 360 degree camera. The camera has two cameras on either side of it, which record complete fisheye, which clever software merges it together and it gives you the effect of having a 360 spin photograph or video. So it shoots 4K 360. It also shoots 24 megapixel photographs. You can also hook this up to your iPad or iPhone, as currently it's only available for iPhone or iPad, and the Android version is coming soon. But if you hook it straight up to your iPad, you can stream directly to Facebook or any other live streaming website. So what's really interesting about it is beyond the 4K and the 24 megapixel capacity, either for video or for photograph, it also has six axes of image stabilization built into the camera. So it creates very, very smooth footage. So if you couple this together with its designated selfie stick, the camera will make the selfie stick disappear, so you'll seem like you have a nice smooth flying camera. It also has a very, very interesting feature which they call bullet time. So what is bullet time? Bullet time means if you attach it onto the tether, the string that comes with it, you can swing it above your head and it shoots up to 240 frames a second. It also makes the string disappear, so it appears as if there's a camera flying around the scene that you're shooting. The whole idea with this camera is that you shoot first and you frame your shots second in post-production. So you can use it with your laptop or your iPad. The software that comes with the iPad, it allows you to decide whether you want a fisheye, you want a little big planet kind of a effect where everything looks like it's a complete circle, or you can shoot normally. So when would that be kind of use? So it could be very interesting for bands who wish to shoot their concerts from the stage. So if they set the camera up in the middle of the stage, they get every single bit of footage, and then they can decide afterwards if they want to pan out to view the crowd, if they want to look at the drummer, and if they want to spin it around like that. Or you can put it up on Facebook or YouTube directly as a 360 video, so the person, your fan, can actually look at it and be right immersed in the performance that you're shooting. It could also be used as well, of course, for shooting interiors of houses. So if you're an auctioneer and you wish to do a fully immersive video of the property, you can shoot this in 360, put it onto your Facebook page, and then the viewer can come along and use their finger to swipe around and look up and look down and see every single bit of the house. So how it works, it comes coupled with an app for the iPad or iPhone. So that's how you control it. You switch the button on at the side, and then you connect it via Bluetooth to the app. It then lets you control whether you do time lapse, whether you do video, whether you do a photograph from the iPad. So I'm recording this video clip on both my camera and also on the Insta360 One. So we're going to put these two videos up so you can see how it was shot and you can see exactly how the whole thing works. Now, also is very interesting as well for somebody like skateboarders or what have you. So you can shoot your 360 video and afterwards you can spin it around and stuff like that. But it also has smart track focusing, so it will stay focused on the person or object that's moving in the middle of the image. It can also be used for water sports, as there's a waterproof housing available for it. So you can attach it to the side of your kayak or whatever it is that you wish to do out on the water. So that's the Insta360 One. As I said, at the moment it's currently only available for iPhone or iPad, but I hear that the Android version is coming soon. Now there is different versions of it that work only with the phone. There's the Insta360 Air, which is for iPad, or apologies, it's just for Android, and there's the Insta360 Nano, which is designated for the phone only. So those are also available, and they're a little bit cheaper than this one, but the Insta360 One is at the moment, it's probably the best one to go for if you have an iPhone or iPad. So that's the Insta360 One. Thank you for watching. If you like this kind of content, be sure to like or subscribe. Thanks.